back to Studio 10. We are out on the weather patio with Brock Fletcher with the selling team with Keller Williams. Welcome back to the patio.
Thank you.
It's been a couple of weeks. Happy New Year. When it comes to real estate, we've talked about this before. It's a tricky time in 2021, and this has been going on for weeks, and it still continues to be an issue for buyers, right?
Yeah, the inventory has been a huge issue. Yeah, we're at like 372 houses available for sale, and that's really only like a 17, 18 day supply at the most.
And we've talked about this before, so we got a couple hundred houses. Usually we're talking the thousands to give people some perspective.
Oh, yeah.
What's the normal number about this time?
Like 2,500, 3,000, somewhere in that range.
And so only got a couple hundred. So here's the deal. We brought Brock in today. He's going to give us some tips for buyers because I know that some of these houses that when they hit the market, literally the sellers are getting offers like 20 dozen to 20 offers for one house.
Yeah, it's not an exaggeration to say we're seeing between 5 and 10, maybe 15 offers, prices going 5,000 to 25,000 over the asking price.
Right, which is great for the seller. But if you're the buyer trying to outbid other people, there's some things that you need to know. So here we go.
Yep.
Here are some tips for home buyers if you want to win that offer. Tip number one, you write the very best offer to start. Tell us more about that.
Definitely. Lead with your best foot. You're probably not going to get a second chance. If you're writing an offer from the perspective of a buyer maybe 4 or 5 years ago where you think, oh, I don't want to make my best offer, that's the wrong mentality in the market we're in. You've got to write what you think is your best offer right out of the gate. Correct.
Yeah.
There's very low negotiation.
Okay. Now, tip number two, this one I think a lot of people might have questions about, so we're going to rely on your expertise here. You should put in an escalation clause in your offer. What does that mean?
Yep. So normally the verbiage is something to the effect of, you know, we will pay $1,000 more than the next highest offer up to X dollars.
Okay.
And the reason for that is, let's say you wrote a really strong offer, but that wasn't your very best offer. And you can put in an escalation clause that will essentially make your offer better and it will increase it to $1,000 over the next closest offer. But you cap it at a point where if it was to go any higher than that, you would be uncomfortable and you wouldn't want to pay that amount. I do recommend an escalation clause in basically every offer.
So everybody should put that escalation clause in there.
I think so.
Okay.
If you're playing to win.
All right. Well, that's what it is right now, too.
It's a competition.
Yeah, it sure is. And our final tip, tip number three, if you are looking to buy a home right now, is that you need to be sure to use a great local lender. So tell us more about that.
Definitely. So when an agent receives an offer that's been written by a buyer's agent, they're looking to see who issued the pre-approval letter. They're looking to see who that lender is. And if they're not a lender that's from the area that has a lot of respect and notoriety, that will work against your buyer. And so I won't name any names or anything like that, but if you're using an out-of-town lender, you're putting yourself at a disadvantage. We've got great local financial institutions. Pick one of them. Get a pre-approval letter from them. When you write an offer, use them for your financing. That's going to give you a chance to be in the competition. You're taking a big risk if you're using a lender from outside of the area.
Okay. It's kind of that name recognition thing.
It is.
Yeah. Okay.
It's a respect issue, and it's an issue of giving yourself the best chance to win.
Okay. Now, I know that we've been having some conversations here at work about this, that the interest rates are super low right now and financing is super low. So is that affecting the real estate market right now? Is that having any impact on it?
Well, it's keeping it still a strong opportunity for the buyers. So interest rates are so low that it only costs the typical buyer about 18% of their income for home affordability. And when you look at the historical rate of about 33%, that lets you know that it's still costing people less money to own a home. And so that's working in our favor. If rates were to skyrocket, that would be detrimental not only to the buyers, but it would immediately take us out of the seller's market.
Okay. All right. Well, there's a lot to it right now, but
there
the key is you want to be that top bidder because the houses, the selections are limited right now.
Yep.
So before we let you go, you got to give out that number because people need as much information as they can get right now, so they're the top bidder.
Absolutely. And I'm happy to answer any questions. My cell number, as always, is 517-303-3262. And I'm here to help, right?
Yep. All right.
Absolutely.
Very good. Well, there's some tips for you. If you're thinking about buying a home, don't lowball.
That's right. There's no opportunity to lowball.
Not right now. That's for sure. All right. Well, thanks for the information.
Thanks, Stephanie.
All right. Thank-